Okay, good day to all. And for our final discussion about the respiratory system, let's now talk about chest and lower respiratory tract disorder. So the lower respiratory tract are composed of your bronchi, the left and right bronchus, the trachea itself, your lungs, and of course the alveoli. Okay, so the most common disorder of the lower respiratory tract is your pneumonia. So ano ba yung pneumonia? So pneumonia is a type of lung infection that can be caused by viruses, bacteria, or even fungi. So it's a viral or bacterial infection, and it actually leads to inflammation in the air sacs mismo, o yung alveoli natin, which may fill with fluid or pus, making it difficult to breathe. So yung alveoli kasi natin, or yung ating air sacs, which is responsible for gas exchange, hollow yun dapat. Ano? Hollow, walang laman. Hangin lang dapat ang pumapasok doon. Or oxygen and carbon dioxide. But in some scenario where there is an presence of infection, possibly bacterial or viral, pwedeng mag-cause ng inflammation, which in turn, pwedeng magkaroon ng fluid yung ating alveoli or yung ating air sacs. So the severity of pneumonia can vary from mild to life-threatening and can affect people of all ages. So wala itong pinipiling edad. But it tends to be more severe in the very young, yung batang-bata, and the very old. Okay, yung elderly natin. And of course, those person that has a weakened immune system. Okay? So what are the common symptoms of your pneumonia? So number one is cough. In most cases, pag may ubo, may kasama tong plema, because there is also the presence of infection, possible na mayroong fever ang pasyente natin, that is possibly accompanied by chills. Okay, so you have your shortness of breath, nahihirapang huminga, chest pain, fatigue, and even nausea or vomiting. So what are the possible treatment for your pneumonia? So the treatment for pneumonia depends, of course, on the cause. Okay, again, balikan natin, what's the cause? Pag bacterial pneumonia, it is typically treated with antibiotics, while antiviral medication may be used for viral pneumonia. So additionally, supportive care such as rest, staying hydrated, and sometimes hospitalization with oxygen therapy might be necessary for severe cases. So kailangan natin ng proper oxygenation. Pag medyo malala na yung pneumonia, kailangan natin ng confinement sa hospital, hospitalization. Okay, so that is necessary pag medyo severe cases na, no? Okay, now, how can pneumonia be prevented? So, preventive measures like vaccination against common causes of pneumonia, pwede tayong gumamit niyan, such as the influenza virus and Streptococcus pneumoniae. May mga vaccine tayo para dyan. Good hygiene practices like hand washing and avoiding close contact with sick individuals can reduce the risk of contracting pneumonia. Okay? So, another disorder of the lower respiratory tract is yung tinatawag natin na ARDS or ARDS or acute respiratory distress syndrome. So acute respiratory distress syndrome is a severe and life-threatening condition that affects the lungs. It is characterized by rapid onset of widespread inflammations of the lungs, leading to build up in the small air sacs in the lungs. So nagkakaroon ng fluid yung ating alveoli. Okay, so it's similar to pneumonia, pero ang ARDS kasi, it's a rapid, and it is very life-threatening. So, nangyari to sa mga pasyente na nagkaroon ng lung infection, okay, possible due to viral infection or bacterial infection. Nung COVID, yung COVID-19 natin, yan, very common yung ARDS sa mga pasyente na mayroong COVID. So, this fluid accumulation severely restricts the lungs from effectively delivering oxygen to the bloodstream and removing carbon dioxide, leading to respiratory failure. Siyempre, sabi ko nga sa inyo before, the air sacs should be hollow. Wala siya dapat laman because dito nangyayari exchange ng carbon dioxide and also ng oxygen. So imagine if it is inflamed and may lamang fluid, saan pupunta yung ating oxygen? Saan pupunta yung ating carbon dioxide. So there should be severe deoxygenation and increase in carbon dioxide in the system, which can be very fatal. Okay? So what are the more common causes of ARDS? So number one, yung sepsis o yung tinatawag natin na severe infection. Severe pneumonia, of course, can cause ARDS. A possible trauma to the lungs, halimbawa na aksidente, tinamaan ang baga, possible na magkaroon ng ARDS due to trauma. Aspiration of vomit or other foreign substances into the lungs. So, nagkaroon ng aspiration. Halimbawa, nasuka ang pasyente at pumasok sa lungs yung mga fluids na yon, or any other foreign substances into the lungs, that can cause ARDS. Yung nalunod, near drowning, syempre, di ba, may fluids na pumasok sa lungs natin. And inhalation of harmful substances can also cause ARDS. Okay, so what are the symptoms of ARDS? So, severe shortness of breath, hirap na hirap huminga. Rapid shallow breathing, okay, kasi nga hindi mag-expand ng maayos yung kanyang air sacs. So, rapid and shallow breathing lang yan. Extreme fatigue due to a low blood oxygen level. You also have your confusion, disorientation, blue tinted skin because of a low blood oxygen levels, the lips or the nails due to lack of oxygen. So those are the symptoms of ARDS. So talaga nakakatakot siya, no? It's very, very life-threatening ang magkaroon ng ARDS. At ang nakakatakot sa ARDS, rapid siya. As in, mabilis talaga. Okay, so what are the common treatments? So same as before pa rin, we have to know the underlying cause. So underlying cause, we treat the underlying cause so we can treat ARDS. So aside from treating the underlying cause, we also should provide supportive care. Now for the underlying cause, for example, it is because of a bacterial infection, you give antibiotic. Okay? Pag viral infection, you give your antiviral medication. Pag sa supportive care naman, proper rest. So pwede rin nating ilagay ang pasyente into a mechanical ventilation to help with breathing and oxygenation. Medication to reduce inflammation in the lungs, mga corticosteroids natin, and sometimes positioning strategies to optimize oxygenation. So, itataas yung pasyente nyo para mas madali siya makahinga. So, usually, ang ARDS is a management in an intensive care unit. It is very common na talagang dinadala siya sa ICU kasi nga it's very life-threatening. Okay. Now, another type of lower respiratory tract disorder, yung tinatawag natin na pulmonary embolism or yung cor pulmonale. So, pag sinabi natin pulmonary embolism, it occurs when one or more arteries in the lungs, okay? One or more arteries in the lungs became black, usually by a blood clot that travels from another part of the body, typically from the legs, or during a deep vein thrombosis. Yung DVT kasi, deep vein thrombosis, karaniwang nangyayari yan, pag prolong kang nakaupo, okay? And then, nagkaroon ng emboli o blood clot, and then, nag-travel siya papunta doon sa iyong pulmonary arteries at nagkaroon siya ng blockage, ang tawag natin doon is pulmonary embolism or cor pulmonale. Okay? So, these clots can restrict or block blood flow to the lungs causing serious complications. So, can you imagine babarahan yung ating pulmonary arteries, may bala, bara. So, paano magpo-flow ngayon ang ano doon, ang blood, di ba? So, it's very fatal. Okay? So, what are the symptoms of a pulmonary embolism? So, common sudden shortness of breath. So, you also have your chest pain that may worsen with deep breathing or coughing. Rapid heart rate, kasi nagkakaroon na tayo ng stress dyan. Cough potentially with bloody or blood-streaked sputum. Sweating, feeling lightheadedness or dizzy. And even fainting or parang ibig-ibig himatayin due again to lack of oxygen. So, what are the common causes? So, kagaya nga na binigay ko sa inyo kanina, DVT or yung ating deep vein thrombosis. The majority of pulmonary embolisms originate as blood clots in the deep veins of the legs. These clots can break loose and travel to the lungs through the blood stream. Okay, so again, DVT, very common. Na ito ang possible cause ng ating pulmonary embolism. Because of the DVT, magkakaroon ng clot formation na pwedeng mapunta sa ating pulmonary arteries. So what are the risk factors common for DVT? Una, prolonged immobility. Okay, for example, like during long flights or bed rest after surgery, yung hindi gumagalaw. Certain medical conditions that increase blood clotting, smoking, obesity, and family history of blood clots can also increase the risk of developing a pulmonary embolism. So for the treatment, of course, since that we are dealing with blood clots here, okay, so ano ibibigay nyo? Anticoagulants. So anticoagulants is the most common treatment na ginagamit natin for a possible pulmonary embolism because an anticoagulant dissolve the existing clot. Okay. So another type of lower respiratory tract disorder, itinatawag natin na cardiac tamponade. So ano ba yung tinatawag natin na cardiac tamponade? So cardiac tamponade is a serious medical condition characterized by the accumulation of fluid or blood in the pericardial sac, the sac that surrounds the heart. This build up of fluid pressure on the heart and prevents it from beating properly. So if you can remember during our discussion about the anatomy and physiology of the cardiovascular system, we have your pericardium. So yung pericardium nyo, pag napuno yan ng tubig, okay, or ng fluid rather, ang tawag natin doon is a cardiac tamponade. So as the pressure on the heart increases, it impairs the heart's ability to pump blood effectively, leading to a decrease in blood flow to the body's organs. So if you can imagine, parang magkakaroon ng tubig yung outer layer ng puso, okay, and because of that, magkakaroon ngayon ng increased pressure na nakapaligid sa puso. If there is an increased pressure due to that fluid, mahihirapang tumibok ang puso kasi para siyang naiipit. Okay? And because of that, magkakaroon ng decreased blood flow to the body's organs. And of course, this reduction in blood flow can be life-threatening if not treated promptly. Okay, so common causes of cardiac tamponade. Number one, trauma, such as a severe blow to the chest. Okay, pag tinamaan ng dibdib, for example, na aksidente, tinamaan ng puso, possible na magkaroon ng trauma, pwede magkaroon ng cardiac tamponade. Another one is your pericarditis or inflammation of the pericardium. So, pag na-inflame ang pericardium natin, yung outer layer ng ating puso, it can also cause a cardiac tamponade. Rupture, a tear in the heart blood vessels that cause bleeding in the pericardial sac. So, it means that pag nagkaroon tayo ng rupture either in the vein or in the arteries, so saan mapupunta yung fluid na yun, yung blood na yun? Sa pericardial sac. Possible yun. Ano? And it can cause a cardiac tamponade. And of course, complication after heart surgery or invasive cardiac procedure can also cause cardiac tamponade. So, symptoms of cardiac tamponade. Number one is difficulty of breathing. Hirap huminga yan. Chest pain, rapid heartbeat, a low blood pressure. Kasi hirap yung pusong tumibok. So, the blood pressure itself is very low. Weakness or lightheadedness because of decreased oxygenation, swelling in the vein of the neck kasi yung blood sa neck na sana natin sa carotid hindi na makabalik sa puso, and also a cold clammy skin. Okay, so what are the possible treatment? So treatment of cardiac tamponade typically involves emergency medical intervention because it can be very fatal. So usually ang ginagawa natin is immediate drainage of the pericardial sac. Tatanggalin yung fluid. I-drain natin. Okay? So, ang tawag natin dito is pericardiocentesis. Okay? So, in some cases, surgery may be necessary to address the underlying cause of the tamponade or to prevent it from recurring. Okay. Now, another lower respiratory tract disorder which is very common, yung tinatawag natin na COPD. Okay? So, or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So, a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is a progressive lung disease characterized by airflow limitations in the lungs. The primary form of COPD includes chronic bronchitis and emphysema. So, what happens here is yung ating alveoli, nawawala na yung ability nila to, what do you call this? Kasi ang alveoli, elastic yan eh. So, pag merong COPD ang isang pasyente, yung elasticity ng alveoli, nawawala na. So, pag halimbawa nag-inhale ka, at lumobo yung alveoli mo due to the inhalation and you have COPD, hindi na siya magde-deflate. So, yun yung tinatawag natin na COPD. Common yan sa mga merong emphysema. Okay, very common. Okay? So, what are the symptoms of your COPD? So, unang-una, you have your chronic cough. Okay? Excessive production of mucus. Shortness of breath, especially during physical activity. Okay? Hirap yung huminga. Wheezing and even tightness in the chest. So, what are the most common causes? Number one, smoking. Again, this is the leading cause of COPD. Prolonged exposure to irritants in cigarette smoke can actually cause an inflammation and damage to the airways and air sacs in the lungs. So, emphysema is a very common disease related to smoking. Okay, and emphysema can actually cause COPD because of the loss of the elasticity of the alveoli. Environmental factors can also cause COPD such as air pollution, and of course yung secondhand smoke natin, kaya iwasan natin yan. Even chemical fumes or yung mga work work-related hazards that can cause inhalations of chemicals na pwedeng mag-cause ng damage sa lungs, which in turn can cause COPD, or common causes natin yan. So what are the possible treatment? Number one, smoking cessation, so stop smoking. The most critical step in managing COPD is, of course, stop smoking and avoid exposure to other lung irritants. So, medications, kailangan natin dito, bronchodilators, para lumuwang yung mga bronchioles, madaling makapasok ang hangin, to help open the airways, and even corticosteroids to reduce inflammation para mawala yung pamamaga ng lungs natin. You also have pulmonary rehabilitation programs that combine exercise, education, and support to improve breathing and overall health. Okay? So, another one is yung oxygen therapy. Supplemental oxygen may be necessary for those with low blood oxygen levels. Siyempre, kailangan natin yan. Surgery, in some cases, lung volume reduction surgery or lung transplant may be considered. Although, ang surgery kasi rito sa Pilipinas, when it comes to lungs, it's very rare. Okay, usually, in Western countries, ginagawa yan. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, very rare ang gumagawa ng ganyang procedure. Okay, so that's it. So that is our lesson about the about the respiratory system. So I hope na may natutunan kayo, and good luck on your midterm examination. So, and I'll be seeing you all on our next meeting. So thank you for listening, and bye class.